She is a patriot among us. She has given us the courage to go out and fight on that wall. I give you, ladies and gentlemen, the spokesperson in South Florida, Joyce Kaufman.
Slightly unbalanced, the inimitable Joyce Kaufman.
Thank you. I come bearing a message from Congressman Alan West. In case you didn't notice, I had a little something to do with him. It says, why is Congressman West not here right now? And the answer is, today the United States House of Representatives passed resolution 34, which establishes the budget for fiscal year 2012 by a vote of 235 to 193. He's doing the work we sent him to do. I could read the whole statement to you, but since he and I think so much alike, I'm just going to tell you, it was on this corner 3 years ago that many of you saw and met Alan West for the first time. And when I brought him out to these events in those days, the Republican Party of South Florida told me that he didn't have a chance of winning an election. And I looked out at the sea of people in this group, and there were 5,000 of us then. And everybody's eyes got wide when he started to talk. And I said, you know what? This guy's a keeper. And he battled his way through that first election from Afghanistan and only lost by a couple of points in a year when the Democrats swept everything, with Obama at the top of that ticket. But the second election, we knew they knew he was coming, so we made sure that we had the forces in place. You were the army that got him elected. So you, if he were here today, he would say, thank you. Now, I don't know why he wants to be up there, but the first thing I have to do is address my friends on the opposite corner. Get a job! You can stand around on street corners all day long because you're taking the money from my pocket and spreading it around the country. It's not your money, it's my money. And I worked too hard for it for you to tell me where it should go. I don't want any more of your banners. I don't need any more move on, move up, move out. Just get away from me. I've had enough, I really have. I get all those emails from the progressives. Were they happy with his speech? Were they unhappy with his speech? The bottom line is, it's our money. We're taxed enough already. Nobody has a right to determine what kind of charity I want to be involved in. I tithe 10%. I don't know if the President of the United States ever did that, but it doesn't show in any of his financial records. I give to charity, and if they left more money in my pocket, I'd be supporting more people and more families in my community instead of watching people standing on lines in stores who are basically swiping credit cards now in lieu of food stamps. We don't even have embarrassment anymore. In this country today, you get a credit card with an American eagle on it. Well, I pay for that credit card, and so do you. And we sent people up to Washington this last round to tell them that I'm taxed enough already. When President Obama declares that there's going to be an increase in taxes for the wealthy, let me tell you something. The wealthy pay all the freight right now. Right now, the top 1% of this country is paying 60% of the taxes. How much more you want from them? In order for us to pay the deficit down, just the 2011 deficit, okay? In order for that to be paid down, you'd have to tax the top 1% of this country 142%. How long you think somebody's gonna work when every dollar they make, they gotta give the government $1.42? Then the second group, the 1% beneath them that makes over 175, or as he likes to say, 250, that's his magic number. The people, including the small corporations that make that kind of money, they'll be taxed at 124%. Well, I got good news for you. People like me in that bracket, I'm not paying a buck and a quarter on every dollar I earn. It ain't happening. And what we're going to be forced to do is have all kinds of tax revolutions in this land. That's not the way the founding fathers designed this. There's no need for me to have to tell the government that they're out of control. Every single 2 years, I get to pick a representative from my community. He should look like me. He should think like me. He should represent me. That's what his name is. His name wasn't Congressman. It's Representative. And that's because he's there to give my perspective. And that's why we got to stop electing lawyers and start electing warriors. They got a fight up there. I don't want any more of these guys who can sit around and make 2,000-page documents that will infringe upon all of my freedoms. I don't want people up there who think by taking away my gun, we're going to have a safer country. Let me tell you something. That Second Amendment, isn't this where I got in trouble before? That Second Amendment was put there to preserve that First Amendment. You give it up, and you'll give up your freedom of religion, you'll give up your freedom of the press, you'll give up your freedom of speech, you'll give up your freedom to stand on this street corner and redress the governing. So you don't back down, we don't get pale, we're not tired. When I see numbers like this, I want to scream, my hair hurts. 5,000 people were out here 3 years ago. Where are they today? You know where they are? They think they won in 2010. They think everything's going to be okay now. Well, I got news for you. There's only 87 people up there who vote the way we think. And that's not enough. We need to get more people elected in the next election. We need a new senator from the state of Florida to join Senator Marco Rubio. We need to challenge these strongholds here in Broward. I'm sick and tired of people saying you can't win that race, it belongs to the Democrats, or you can't win that race as an independent. It's time for people to get, as Mr. Giles said, get some testosterone and run in races and challenge the establishment. When Congressman Ron Klein stood on a stage next to now Congressman Alan West, let me tell you something. Anybody in that audience knew who they wanted fighting for them. That was as clear as a bell. You need warriors. You've got to start electing them. And let me tell you the last part of this. A lot of them are going to wear high heels. The warriors in Washington right now are being led by a beautiful woman named Congresswoman Michelle Bachmann. The warriors in this country are waiting to hear from the big mama, Governor Sarah Palin, in the next couple of months. And that's going to tell you a lot about the direction that this country is going in. You're going to find women warriors rising up the ranks in local politics. Now, I'll tell you what my plans are, because I'll be here next year, same time, same place. Because this is where I get to meet with you and to just feel like we're all on the same page. What's happening in Washington right now is a complete abdication of their responsibilities to have run this country without a budget, to have scared us to death and say they were going to close down the government, and then to hold a man like Congressman West hostage by throwing in a defense appropriations budget so that he couldn't vote against that continuing resolution because it said the military wasn't going to get paid. Well, I have news for you. The military gets paid at the discretion of the commander-in-chief. The only person who could have stopped their paycheck is sitting in the White House, not the Congress, and these guys got played. And they get played because we're not paying attention. We got to start paying attention to the subtleties. You have to read. And all of these abdications of responsibilities are going to result in block grants to the states. From now on, your Medicaid, within 6 months, Medicaid is going to get block granted to the states. And now is when you're going to appreciate Governor Rick Scott. Now is when you're going to start wondering why it was important to have a Republican-led legislature full of conservatives who are battling against illegal immigration, who are trying to pass laws. That's when it matters. So I'm telling you right now, there are people in this audience who've been running for office. There are people who want to run for office. Start thinking about these state house and state senate races. That's where the power is going to be. And I'm going to be there for you. You know I'll give you a microphone, and you know I'll give you money. Not everybody has to go to Washington. Some people got to stay here with us. And by the way, you know what the Founding Fathers said? You know why it's a two-year term? You know why it's a six-year term? Because they were supposed to go up there, get something done, and then return to their communities and start back in their businesses, in their practices, and live with us like real people. Washington, D.C. is 10 miles surrounded by reality. They get up there, they forget who they are, they move up there. It's a whole different world. It's disgusting. And I will close with this because, of course, so many members of the press are here, and this is one of the main reasons that they stayed in the heat. I have not made a decision yet. I'm being urged to run for office, and I have not made a decision yet. And that's all I'm going to say. Nobody knows which district. Nobody knows when I'm going to announce. And I really like it that way. Thank you. Keep doing what you're doing. And as for the guys over there who think they know something about something, how come there's only eight of you?